Welcome to part 4 of my rigging tutorial. So I've fitted the biped to the goblin's mesh, and you can see here it's fitting as well as possible. So it's time to start attaching the mesh to the biped skeleton. So the first thing I'm going to do is unfreeze that mesh. You can do this by hitting unfreeze all, or just unfreeze by name. Now I can select the mesh again. I'm going to uncheck see-through. So now I can see it. And I'm actually going to go ahead and make the skeleton see-through now. So I'm selecting the entire skeleton. You can do that by going to the top, scrolling down to the last thing in the list, hitting shift, and clicking it. So now I've selected the entire skeleton. And I'm going to hit see-through. So if I do that, I can see the skeleton, but I've lost all the colors there. So now, I'm going to go to the Modify panel, and we're going to do something called Physique. It's a modifier that you add to the mesh, which allows you to attach the mesh to the skeleton. So I select the mesh. You'll notice that it's an editable mesh, and yours should be either that or an editable polygon. And you can see here I have this button called Physique. If you don't see this button, you can actually edit your list by going to this modifier list. There's a drop-down panel, and you can scroll, and you'll see Physique under the P section, because it's in alphabetical order. So anyway, here we go. I'm hitting Physique. So I've added this Physique modifier to this goblin mesh. Now what I'm going to do, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to initialize it. This button here attaches it to the node, which is your root of your skeleton. So I'm going to click that. I'm going to hit H. And you'll notice now it says pick object, not select object. So now I'm going to go ahead and pick the root of my biped. That's gob. Pick it. You get this physique initialization menu. The only thing I do is I uncheck create envelopes. Envelopes are a very quick way of making a mesh, but I tend to want to manually weight the vertices, and I'll get to that in a little bit. I'm going to uncheck that, and I'm going to click initialize. So the first thing here, when I open this up, I see that I have all these different options. So I tend to go into this vertex mode. When you're in this mode, you see all these vertices, or vertices. What I'm going to want to do is attach them to the skeleton. Now you'll notice here, instead of the classic skeleton, you're seeing these yellow lines. These are the actual bones. And what you're going to want to do is attach each vertex to a bone. When the vertexes are blue, it means they're not attached to anything. So for instance, if I was to select all of these vertices by just dragging and assign to link, that's what you're going to want to do to attach it. I could attach all of these things to just one bone, like the thigh. And what that's going to do is every time I move the thigh, the entire thing is going to move. But of course I don't want that. So remove from link. Now they're all blue again. Now you have these different vertex types. Red is deformable, green is rigid, and blue, of course, is unassigned. So I tend to use green for things that aren't going to move, like anything like the top of the skull. You don't necessarily want that to move too much with the rest of the mesh. But red is generally great for our purposes. So I'm going to go ahead and start with the top of the head. If I go into my left viewport, click off there, let's say I want to go ahead and select all of this stuff right here. So just bit by bit, I'm going to go ahead and attach this to the head. Now, you want to be careful because you'll see there's actually two yellow lines here. One of those might be for the ponytail. So I'm going to press P and make sure, just by rotating around, that I have the right link. So you can either make it a green assignment or a red assignment. I'm choosing red, and I'm going to click that link. And the next thing we're going to do is lock it. That means that it can't be changed. I can still select it and unlock it, but it makes it more easy to assign a lot of vertices. Now here's where the process gets pretty tedious. This is the part of the rigging process that most people don't like. and it takes a while, but in the end it gives you a lot of control over what your character looks like when it's animated. So you can probably just fool around with this and guess what each of these things does. Select by link means that when I select any particular link, it shows me what's assigned to it. So far I've only got that little bit assigned. And the next tutorial is going to be about weighting the vertices, or giving each vertex a weight so that the vertices on this joint will have a little bit of influence from this joint, and vice versa, so that the elbow will look more natural when it bends. But for now, the first thing you'd probably want to do is block out the really easy things that aren't going to move very much. So for instance, the tips of the toes, these are always going to be assigned to the toe bone. You don't want these to be influenced by anything else. And so that's pretty easy to just assign it and lock it.